stood by and stuck up for those Labour values of unity, of strength, of achieving things together. And that's how we're going to win this election. I've called on people to register to vote. Every local authority in the land has called on people to vote. Every TV channel has called on people to register to vote. What are they worried about? 2 million young people registering. Those going through mental health crises and stress, unable to get the help they need and deserve because 6,000 mental health nurses have lost their jobs in the past 7 years. None of this is necessary, none of this is right. It's making the poorest and most vulnerable, it's making the hardest working in our public sector jobs pay the price of the banking crisis of 2008. I tell you who should pay the price of the banking crisis of 2008. The bankers who caused the crisis. And so, you then look at so many other things in our society. This election is not about dividing this country between the elderly and the young. It's not about dividing one region against another. It's not about the politics of division. Look around this wonderful audience here today. Who are we? We're young, we're old, we're black, we're white, we're men, we're women, we're straight, we're gay, we're disabled, we don't have disabilities, we're all kinds of things. Misery and distrust, and you haven't built a house, you haven't employed a nurse, you haven't trained a doctor, you've achieved absolutely nothing. We are going in absolutely the opposite direction of bringing people together and investment for the future of all of us. And that starts with how we treat our children. Why should our primary school heads, our secondary school heads, have to go through the misery of deciding which teacher to get rid of, which subject to end, which teaching assistant to send down the road, which books not to buy, which desks not to replace, which facilities won't happen, which school journeys won't take place, because there's some weird funding formula that takes money away from the vast majority of our schools for the first time for many, many decades. I find that absurd. I find it unnecessary, and I find it wrong. I want to lead a government that invests in our children, not takes away. Yeah! And you know what? Because hungry children find it really hard to learn and really hard to concentrate. That's why we have free school meals for some children, other children don't get it, the children that are working poor don't get it, and so on and so on. I believe in a society that cares for all and a community for all. So a Labour government will bring in free school meals for every child in every primary school in the whole country. And you know what? The experience of those children being properly fed in school every day together rather than going into separate rooms to have their lunch because some get free meals, some bring sandwiches and so on. Bring our children together, the better they might understand the power of a community being together. Yeah! And earlier today we launched our culture manifesto here in Hull, the city of culture, here in Hull, the city of poetry, here in Hull, the place that has invested so much in the creative arts and so much else. And one of the proudest things in that cultural manifesto we put forward, yes, the investment in museums and galleries and theatres, yes, the opportunities for music space, for entertainment and for rehearsal, but also the pupil premium for arts, so that every child will get a musical instrument. As it was a Labour Johnson set up the Arts Council and started the process of public investment in arts for all. Because in every young person there is music, in every young person there is ambition, there's ideas, there's creativity. Let's make sure all those ideas are able to come up and those children are not ignored and left behind. That's our pledge and that's our promise. As I travel around the country, and I do travel a great deal around the country, is the number of people I meet sleeping on the streets. A million people denied the social care they need at the present time. There are thousands at any one moment in hospital waiting to leave hospital, but they can't because there's no social care package available for them. And every local authority is under real pressure on this. And when we started pressing the government on this, they did a deal with one local authority in Surrey. And for the Tories, it seems that Surrey is the hardest word because they wouldn't offer even a meeting to Hull, to Newcastle, to Liverpool, to Manchester, to anybody else. They just wanted to do a deal for the constituencies represented by themselves. Well, I'm sorry, I want there to be good quality social care for all in Surrey, in Hull, in Newcastle, in Manchester, in the whole country. Woo! Because we're not into those politics of division. We're into the politics of bringing people together. And so, whilst they would take away homes if they could, in order to pay for social care, whoa, we say it's a public responsibility to care for those in need, many of whom are elderly, whoa, some of whom are disabled, some of whom have learning difficulties, but are all people, all need help, whoa, and all deserve help from all of us.